Hello guys, my name is Evans and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I'm going to continue looking at the 2016 IGCSE ICT specimen paper. In the last video, I started looking at this paper and we did a section on data analysis. And in this video, I'm going to do a section on web authoring, and then I'll put up another video where I'll do a section on presentation. Right, so in the last video, we finished off data analysis and we had to start looking at web authoring. And if you remember very well, in the last video, I did set up a folder, which was my work area. And inside there, I had all these files that I was working on. And I'm going to pick it up from there. Okay, so let me go back to my question paper. Okay, so you are going to help develop a web page for Super Scuba. The web page will be part of a website used to sell scuba diving holidays around the world. And step, I don't know if this is step or what, doesn't seem it's a step, but we are told to create a new folder called p3 underscore html. And yeah, so let's just do that. So in my work area, I'm going to create a folder called p3 underscore html. Okay, and let me just put this here. So we're told locate the files and store them, we locate the following files and store them in this folder that we just created, and these are the files that we need here. So I'm going to get these files. So p3 image 1 2 3 4 5 6, then I need the logo and I need sunset, and then super htm, which is this one, I think, yeah, and I need the style sheet, these files. So I'm gonna just drag these files inside here, okay, just like that. And I've put them in this folder which I just created here. All right, so inside here, just verify that you have these files listed here as the same one that you have in your folder. Alright, so step 21. A student has tried to create a style sheet to be used with a web page. The web page and the style sheet must work in any browser. All color codes are in hexadecimal. Okay, so the style sheet should define the following styles: H1 color, red, and so on and so forth. And all these are the attributes of or the different values for various attributes such as color, font, and stuff. Okay, so we need to set our styles to these. Okay, from H1 all the way to body, we need to set them to this. Okay, so the question says, open the style sheet p3style.css in a suitable software package. The style sheet was not finished and contains a number of errors. Correct and complete this style sheet using the information above. Okay, so we need to open this style sheet and then we need to adjust the style, whatever contents will be in that style sheet. All we need to know is that this is the correct information that the style sheet should reflect. Okay, so I'm going to go back in my folder and I'm going to open this style sheet. Now, there are different packages that you can use to open the style sheets. You can open it with Notepad, but I'm going to open it with FrontPage because it's the one that I'm going to be using to create web pages. Okay, so I'm going to just start a blank web page and I'm going to open, browse to my desktop and change here to go here and pick up the style sheet. Okay, so this is the style sheet that we have, and from the question paper, we are told that the style sheet should reflect this. So let's just take a look at this style sheet and see if there are any errors that this student was working on. So let's start. H1, okay, color is reddy green. Yeah, so you can automatically see here that this student was actually trying to describe the color, but he was using text. And I don't know if there is such a color as reddy green. Yeah, so let's help this student come up with proper hexadecimal colors. Remember, the question tells us that all the color codes must be in hexadecimal. And if you check here, these color codes are not in hexadecimal. This is just text. Check out this one, H2, dark blue, darkish blue. And then let's see, font, family, Arial. And then font size, wow, mega big. Yeah, mega big. Okay, so, and then biggish. This is... Now you missed that. You may start to laugh as though it's but you know, sometimes you find you're marking many ICT papers and just student papers, you really see funny answers that student give when they really don't know what they're supposed to write. But what I'm going to do is we're going to edit this style sheet and really give it the hexadecimal values that it should have on the colors, and then put the font family that is listed, and then also change the font size as well as the alignment of the text and the background colors and so on and so forth. So let's start with the color codes for H1. So let me go back to so the color code is that you should have the components. Red component should be FF, and FF, I'm sure you guys know hexadecimal numbers. Maybe just for the sake of the guys, some guys who may not know the hexadecimal numbers, what I'm gonna do, the hexadecimal numbers are represented by RGB. You have two values that they always start with hashtags. The first two values represent red, so I'll say it's supposed to be red, and then the next two values represent green, and the last two values represent blue. Okay, and we know that hexadecimal numbers, they range from 1 to 9, and then let me just say 1 to 9. No, not 1 to 9, 0 to 9. Okay. And then you can also have A to F, okay? So meaning all numbers that are between 0 and 9 inclusive, they are valid, and all numbers between A and F, or rather all letters between A and F are valid, A and F inclusive. So for example, you can have red which is represented by FF, okay? The red components when it's on, and you don't have, so you start with a hashtag, then the red component is on, remember RRR, which is red, and then the green component is off, which is 00, and the blue component is off, and this gives you the color red. So if you want green, so the red component should be off, then the green component should be on, rather it should be FF, and the blue component should be off, and this will give you green. Okay, and then lastly, if you want blue, then the red component should be off, the green component should be off, and FF, which is the highest value that you can get, the highest hexadecimal number that you can get, which is F, and this will give you blue. Okay, any color combination is actually manipulation of these values in between here. You can have, for example, B there, you can have A there. All these values, as you manipulate them, you actually come up with different combination of color cones. Okay, so that is the hexadecimal value. Okay, so let me go back here. So we are told that the red component is FF, and the green component is FF as well, and the blue component 0. So just by looking, when you combine red and green, you're likely to come up with a color that is similar to yellow, if not yellow. Okay, so just by looking, but you're not expected to know that when you combine this color, you just need to know which one is absolute blue, which one is absolute green, which one is absolute red, and then you also need to know what happens when you reduce the hexadecimal values. For example, check here, this is FF. What happens when you reduce it to 0, from FF to 0? You need to know that it actually shuts down that color and makes it black, for example. What happens when you reduce, maybe say, a color from FF to, let's say, to CC? So know that when you have FF, these are bright colors. So as you reduce the hexadecimal values, you are actually getting closer and closer to a black. So which means the color is becoming darker and darker. So sometimes in the exam, you'll be asked to make a color darker. Just know that when it is light, like this FF, any color that is going to make it dark is actually going to be one that is heading towards zero. Okay? So please take note of that. I just took time to explain that so that you guys don't struggle. Okay, so please, I don't want to waste much of the time in this video already. I've spent so much time or some time explaining the values, the hexadecimal values. So I'm going to go back here. And so let's start with this color here. We're told that H1 color should be, a red component should be FF, and green component should be FF, and blue component should be zero. Okay, so hexadecimal numbers or color code starts with hashtag, and so you have FF for red, FF for green, and 00 for blue. Now remember, these values are supposed to be in pairs. Okay, so you can't just put one like this and say, okay, let's say since it was written FF, and then because blue was just like that, then you put a zero like that. No, don't. These values are supposed to move in pairs. So you need one more zero, and that color actually becomes the color described here. Okay, red component FF, green component FF, and blue component, even though it is just a single zero there, it is supposed to be double digits. Okay, so the font, I don't know if this is trebuchet. Some words are very difficult to pronounce, especially if this, I don't think this is an English word. I don't know, it sounds like a French word, but it is trebuchet. If it is French, then it's like trebuchet. All right. Okay, so we should have this font type, and then if it is not available, then we pick Arial. If Arial is not available, then we pick the browser's default sans serif font. Okay, so let's go back here. So font family, if it is there, we pick trebuchet. Okay, now the moment you put comma, you're saying that suppose this is not there, can you pick if this is there? Okay, so if trebuchet is not there, then pick Arial. Okay, if Arial is not there, then comma, can you pick any sans serif font? This is very important, guys. You're given options here. You know, sometimes when you're just creating style sheets, we pick, let's say you pick Arial and stuff, and then some browsers don't have Arial as the font family. Okay, and you find that maybe it may just ruin the appearance of your text. And so this is a very good way of specifying. So your first priority will be trebuchet. If it is not there, then the browser will try to pick Arial. If Arial is not there, then it will try to pick any sans serif font. Okay, so that is very important, guys. I hope I've made myself clear there. So the font size is supposed to be 24 points high. So I'm going to go back here. And a font size, it can't be mega big. Let's make it 24 PT. Okay, and we go back here. And the alignment is supposed to be center. Okay, so center aligned. Okay, so that should be fine. Now, guys, the problem that we have here is that style sheets, let me just say, for example, the Cambridge papers are UK English standard. What I mean by that is that, let me just open a Word document. What I mean, guys, by that is that, for example, check, this is United Kingdom dictionary that we are using. And let's try to type center and do that. You see that it is not underlined, center. Okay, but try to type this type of center and you will see that it is automatically underlined, because this type of center is the American version, it's using the American dictionary, and this one is using the UK dictionary. So if I change the language here and made my USA to be the default and say okay, you will see that automatically the city center is not underlined. So if I type center and I type center, this center is now being accepted because it's coming from the USA format. There are many words that you can compare. So for example, color and color, like that. You see that this color is underlined because this is the UK version, but my dictionary is changed to United States. And so when you are working with style sheets, the dictionary that style sheets accept is actually the USA dictionary. Okay, so when you, if for example you wanted to change color for the style sheet and you typed color like this, okay, it is going to flag an error, and you find that your color may not even change because you're using the USA dictionary and you're trying to type a UK standard spelling of color, and that becomes an error. So you need to know from your style sheet, for example, check this color. This is USA color. Okay, but if you scroll down, just check. Wow, yeah, take a look at this one. This is the UK color. So this color and this color are different. Okay, and if you left this color like this, it's going to flag an error. It won't recognize this color. Okay, so you would need to change this one to conform to this one. Okay, so the reason is that style sheet actually understand the USA English dictionary. So that's it. So the same thing with center. So if you check center, this is the UK way of writing center. So you need to change it to the USA way of writing center by adding ER like that. That's when it's going to work out. Okay, that's when it's going to work out. Otherwise, you find that all your work is not going to be recognized. Okay, so we're done with H1. Let's go to H2 quickly. This is dark blue, darkish blue. It is darkish blue. Let's find out which one did. Okay, so it's H2, red is 0, green is 0, and blue is CC. Remember what I was saying, that as you're moving from FF, going down there, you're making the color darker. And this is why the guy, in his ignorance, just went and wrote darkish blue. So let's change darkish blue to the color that we want. Okay, so let's go. It's supposed to be 00 red component, 00 green component, and CC as the blue component. Next, the text is supposed to be Arial, supposed to be 16 point, and should be right aligned. So let's go back there. Font family Arial, it's okay. Font size, remove biggish and make it 16 pt. And text align, make it right. Okay. Let's go back. Okay, so done with this one. H3 color, red component 0, green component 0, blue component CC. It's supposed to be Arial, 12 point, and it should be center aligned. Okay. So H3 is supposed to be the same color code as this one. So hashtag 00 component of red, 00 green, and CC blue. Font family Arial, font size 12, and alignment supposed to be, let me just verify, alignment is supposed to be center. Okay, like that. Next, the list. Okay, let's define the list. The list is supposed to be red. Okay, red component 0, green component 0, and blue component 0. And supposed to be Arial, and supposed to be 12 points high, left aligned, and the bullet type is supposed to be, style is supposed to be disc. Okay, so this is gonna take us, so that's everything 0. So this is black, this is literally black. Okay, and the font is Arial 12 and left aligned. Okay, let me just go back there. So you see he even wrote black. So hashtag 00000. Okay, Arial, font size 12. Alignment, let me just verify, alignment is supposed to be left, which is okay. That's the spelling is not okay. Check, it's here let. Okay, so you be careful there. Need to verify, so it's supposed to be left, and then the style, list style is supposed to be disc. It's fine. So list style is supposed to be disc, bullet supposed to be disk. So just verify that the spelling for disk as well. So sometimes you may find that there is K at the end there, like disk, like that. This is the disk for a hard disk, maybe. And you may just say, ah, it's disk, but you just see it's not working out. So let's put disk with a C like that. So list style type disk. And so let's go back to now. Let's configure the paragraph. The color is supposed to be black as well, which is 00, and supposed to be aerial, and supposed to be 12 points and left aligned. So come back here. Color is black, so hashtag 00000, and supposed to be aerial, and the mid is supposed to be 12. The alignment is supposed to be left aligned. Okay, so left aligned is fine. And the last one is body. So the body color must be red component 0, green component CC, and blue component supposed to be FF. So this color is going to be a lighter blue, because you have a full color blue, and then you have some components of green, which is a darker green. And when you mix these two, I think you should have something like this type of blue here, close to this type of blue. Okay, so I'm gonna change that. So background color, and remember we were supposed to change this color to color, and then change the red component hashtag 0, and this one is hashtag CC, and then FF. Okay, so that should do. So let me just explain one thing. You're supposed to know how to manipulate the color codes and the text, and you know, you're supposed to know how to work around these colors, okay, just from Notepad, and you're supposed to know how to prepare or create a style sheet from this. Okay, so just verify that what you have here is this actually what you have here. Please, I'm not gonna go back here to start verifying this because of time. But if I find that later on in the video that I made a mistake down there, I'll come back and put up a comment and spot out the error and say, here, I made a mistake, and this is what you're supposed to do. But I'm not gonna go back and start comparing if this is correct with this, okay, compared to this one. Okay, man, I'll leave that up to you. You're supposed to do that. But I'll assume, suppose everything is okay. So I've just shown you what you're supposed to do. Okay, so let me go back to the question. Okay, so correct and complete the style sheet using the information above. We just done that. Save the style sheet in your P3_HTML folder. Use the file name style followed by your candidate number. For example, if your candidate number is 9999, then you call the file style 999.cs. CSS. Okay, so I'm gonna go here, file, save as. Please don't click on save here, because once you click on save, then you have saved this style as style.css, p3 style.css. okay, we've been given what we're supposed to save it as, so go and save as, and then call it style. Okay, style, and then my candidate number, as usual, I'll use 0001. Okay, and it's supposed to be saved as a CSS file. Okay, so some people would explicitly state that .css like that, and some people would not even use that. So because it is already a style sheet file, we'll just click on save, and you'll see that front page automatically adds CSS at the end there. Okay, so that should be fine. So next, take screenshots showing the text of your style sheet and place this in your evidence document. Make sure that the name is clearly visible. So I'm gonna go back here and take a screenshot of this. Okay, and I'm gonna go in my folder and paste it in my evidence. So come back here, open my evidence document, and this is supposed to be step what? This is supposed to be step 21. Okay, so I'll just step 21, and I'll paste that. Now you're gonna have to crop this so that this is more visible. As you can see, this is actually not very visible. When you just print it like this, it won't be very visible. Okay, what we're interested in is to have this printed like this, so that the examiner can mark and see your text nicely. So you need to crop this and resize it nicely so that it is more visible. I'm not gonna do that for the sake of time. Okay, next step, step 22. Using a suitable software package, open the file p3super.htm and then you attach the file style sheet saved in step 21 to this web page. So I'm going to go back here and go to file and open. I'm going to go to my desktop and P3 and open this one, P3 Super, and like that. Okay, so this is my style. This is my program. An X like this indicates that there should be an image here, but it's not been shown. It's very important you take note of this. There's an image here. Because of this X I'm seeing here, the image is supposed to show. So how you can know that there's an image, just right click there and check picture property. Okay, and you check that you have there's already some style and stuff. So I don't know. Yeah, so when you go to general, it shows you the picture that is there. Okay, there's a picture that is there, sunset.jpg. So I don't know for some reason why it is not being displayed, but we'll figure it out, and then we'll just check the dimension for the picture that is existing there, and then we're going to put it back as a picture. Okay, so for this stage, let's attach the style sheet. Okay, it's supposed to be style sheet links, and then add style, and then browse, and then pick up the style that you saved, which is this one, and I'll say okay. And okay. And you see that the style sheet, so you see the blue I was talking about is somewhat like that, not exactly as I described, but it was still a blue, but lighter blue. Okay, so we have Super Scuba, and that is when. So that is fine. Style sheet is attached. Replace the text, candidate name, center number, candidate number with your name, center number, and candidate number. So I'm going to go back here at the bottom here where it's candidate name. I'm going to replace this with my name. So I'll say Chikasa Evans, and center number, I'll replace this with my center number, ZM556, and candidate number as usual, 0001. Okay. Step 23, done. Set the table border to 2. So let's go back here. Table border to 2. So right click on this table and go to table properties and set the table border to 2. Okay. Next step, set the cell padding to 8 pixels. Okay, so go back here. Cell padding is this one here. Set it to 8 pixels. Okay. Next step, set the table width to the window, to fill the window, or I mean the width of the window. What this means is that from this end here to this end here, the web page should occupy the width of the size of the window in the browser, or the space available in the browser. Okay, so to be able to do that, you need to specify the width. Now the width is currently specified in pixels to 400 centimeters. Now please don't use pixels when you want to fill the width of this the window, because if you use pixels, they are dependent on the computer that you are using. Okay, so if, for example, the resolution for my screen is the maximum, for example, is, let's say it, let me just verify that the maximum resolution for my screen, let me just go back here, sorry about that, let me just verify the resolution that I have for my screen. Okay, you pardon me, I'm using multiple displays, so I can't really check for the dimensions of my screen. The resolution here, I can't really access that. Okay, but I should believe I'm using, let me just check from the recorder. I think the recorder should show me something. Yeah, okay, so here are my dimensions from the recorder. Is 1440 by 900, 1440 being the length from the left to the right, and 900 being the length from top to bottom. Okay, so what is happening is that if I put, say for example, 1440 as the width, fine, on this computer it will fill the screen. Okay, but if someone goes to a computer that has a higher resolution than my computer, it won't fit. Or if you use a smaller screen, which is say 1020 as the width, then and you put it as 1440 it won't just fit, okay? So better use percentage. So in percentage, we know that absolute or the exact value is supposed to be 100%. So 100% of whatever screen is available, that's what we do, that's what we put, okay? So I'll go back here. So I'm done with filling the window. I've set it to 100%. So I'm going to go back here and say apply. And okay, automatically you see that, let me just close this one, and you see that the it occupies the screen that is available, okay? So step 27, replace the text, place logo here with the image, logo.jpg, p3logo.jpg, yeah, right, so, you have to look for the text that is there. Now, for some reason, it seems the style that, and I want you guys to take note of this, I can't seem to find the text that has been talked about. But if I split and go to my text, the text that is being talked about is supposed to be, let me just see the text once more, supposed to be, place logo here, okay, place logo here. So let me just copy this, place logo here, and you need to look for the text where it says place logo here. It is this one here, okay, this is the text, and you can see it is actually here. So let me just highlight this so that you see that the text is actually here, okay, it's here. And now the reason it is not visible is because it has, we have the black background and the text is probably black. Okay, so this is something very important. So alternatively, what you can do, if you can't find it, just press Control F on your keyboard and type in the text, place logo here, okay, place logo here, and say find next, and you see that it will highlight the text where the text is. So once you do that, then in the code it will show the text where it is, and then what you just have to do is to delete that text. Once you delete it, then you need to insert a picture from file, and the picture that we're supposed to insert is actually coming from here. It's supposed to be P3 logo, and say okay. I hope it works out. For some reason doesn't show the picture. Okay, it has shown. I was getting worried, for some reason it's not showing the picture. Okay, so that's the logo there. All right, so set the most appropriate image for those located for task 3 and use it to replace these three texts. So starfish, shark, and turtle. So let's come back here. I'll go back to design view. Starfish is here. So I'll replace this text, delete it, and go to insert picture from file. And I'll look for the picture for starfish. So let me just change. So I don't know if this can enlarge. But this looks like starfish. Okay. Just insert it. Yeah, there we go. Starfish there. And then I'll insert another picture. By the way, you can just click here. Don't need to go into insert one. Just click here. And then picture of a shark. Okay, this looks like fish. I think this one should be a shark. Let me just zoom in. Just hold Control key on your keyboard and roll the mouse key. The mouse wheel, okay, just roll it up. If you roll it down, you zoom out. You roll it up, you zoom in. And there I can see that this looks like a shark. Okay, so I'll put it there. There you go, shark. And for a turtle, delete the text, go to picture, and let's zoom in again. Yeah, there we go. This is a turtle. Okay, and that's that. So next step, resize the image placed in step 28 so that they are 200 pixels wide and maintain their aspect ratio. So let's go back here. Let's begin to resize these images so that they are 200 pixels wide. Go to picture properties and make sure aspect ratio is maintained. Guys, I'll repeat this. I did say this in another video that aspect ratio is supposed to be maintained. What happens if you don't maintain aspect ratio is that when you change the width, for example, the height doesn't change, it remains 300 pixels. The overall appearance of the picture is that it will be distorted. Okay, so what we want is the picture not to be distorted. What we want is that the picture should adjust automatically. For example, I put 200 here, and you see that automatically the height also adjusts. Okay, so I'll say okay. The same thing with this other picture. From 400, I'll put 200, and you see that automatically the height adjusts, and the starfish as well. Picture properties, make sure aspect ratio is checked, and it's supposed to be 200 pixels. Please don't put 200%, it's supposed to be 200 pixels, and that should be fine. Okay, next, save the web page. Okay, no, we skipped one step. Here, step 30, make the image P3 logo JPG a hyperlink to a second to send an email message to super scuba at whatever. So for the sake of typing, I'm just gonna copy this, guys. I'm feeling lazy to type again, and the subject should be holiday inquiry. So we go back here, the image is this one, okay, and we're supposed to insert a hyperlink. The hyperlink is supposed to be an email address, and supposed to be mail to super whatever, and the subject is supposed to be holiday inquiry. Okay, supposed to be holiday inquiry, and nothing else to be put there, and just say okay. So next step, save the web page. So display the web page in a browser. If necessary, resize your browser window so that it fills the entire screen. Take a screenshot of the screen, entire screen, and place this in your evidence document. So guys, what I'm gonna do, like I said in the beginning, that you see that this is a picture, but it's not visible. Okay, we know it's sunset picture. If you go back here and go to general, you see that it is sunset picture. So let me just try to browse and go to there, and go to specimen P3 and pick up sunset picture and say okay. I hope it can. Okay, so it has put the picture, but we have lost the dimensions of the picture. We don't know the dimensions that it had. So before I even do that, let me just check the dimensions for this picture. So I'll go back to the source code. I'll go to split, and then the source, you see that the width is actually 366. Okay, so I'm gonna go back here, go to picture and general, and then browse, and then reattach the picture there. I'm not so sure why the picture is not showing. It is supposed to show, but I'm not sure why it is not showing. So once you do that, appearance, and then the width is supposed to be 360. For some reason I can't type there. What I'll do, I'll change the picture. I'll go back here to picture properties and change the picture to 366 as the width. I'll allow the aspect ratio to change in comparison to the height. That should be fine, so that the image is not distorted. And I'll say okay, and there you go, the picture has been put with the appropriate size. Okay, so I don't know, for some reason why Cambridge put up a picture, and I tried to check it in another browser, it didn't just load up the picture. So I don't know, for some reason, once I come across the perfect reason, I'll probably comment it out there, and I'll explain why it happened like that. But for now, I just had to reattach the same picture and pick up the same width that it had. So you notice that it has also brought in the height for the picture. I don't think this is an issue, because the aspect ratio was maintained for the picture, which means that when we change the width to 366, automatically it adjusts to suit the appropriate height that we can get from this size. Okay, so let me go back here. Right, so we are told to save the web page, and then we display the web page in a browser, and if necessary, we resize the browser window so that the file is review the entire screen. So let me go back here. Let me just go to file and preview in browser and say yes. And so this is my browser. So you notice sometimes when you put the window, it may be enlarged like this. Okay, it may be like that, and the window is not fully visible. So you hold Control key and press minus on the numeric keypad down there. You press minus, and then you reduce the size of the image so that it is visible. So what I'm going to do is to copy the screen, take a screenshot of this, and then I'll take a screenshot of that, and then that should be that. Okay, so I would need to paste this. this is here, okay. Okay, so we place this image in there. So that's step 30. So let's put step 30 in our image document evidence, and step 30. So let's just put there and say step 30 and paste it there. Okay, so for some reason just goes down there. So I'll take this down there as well. Alternatively, what you can do is actually to resize this. Okay, just resize it so that it can fit on one page. Okay, that should be fine. Next, what I'm gonna do is take a copy of the HTML source code and place in the evidence document. So that's step 30. I'll type down there, I'll put HTML source code, and I'll go back to my front page and go to source code, and I'll copy this entire code as it is. Okay, right click, copy, and go back to the evidence document and paste it down here. Okay, so that is your code. Okay, now yeah, so I think this should mark the end to the web authoring. I'm sorry that the video has taken somewhat a bit longer than I expected it, because I had to explain some stuff also, but I hope this has been informative for you guys. Subscribe to my channel. You get the advantage of getting a notification whenever I put up a new video, and you can watch and catch up. I'm continuing to do new videos. I'll do another video by the end of the day on this same paper. I'll start to look at a section on presentation, PowerPoint, and it is a short one, so it shouldn't take us so much time. Maybe in the next just 30 minutes or so it should be done. But nevertheless, if you have any question or something that you need clarity, you guys just comment it out in the comment box below the video. And if you have again any paper that you want me to do or help you with, just comment it out there as well. I'll have a look at it. If I have time, I can do it as soon as possible, and I can notify you that the paper and the video is available. So guys, thank you so much. This has been Evans, and I'll see you in the next video.